You've had a lot of firsts since the draft, first training camp, first summer league. How are you feeling on the eve of your first regular season NBA game?
Feeling lucky as always, but also focused, locked in, you know. And we know what we got to do. We got to start with the good way to start is with a win.
How long have you been dreaming of that day?
Damn. As long as I got memories, so can't really tell you.
You think you're going to be able to get that nap in tomorrow?
About napping?
Yeah, you're going to get your nap in tomorrow?
Man, I don't know. I never know, but I might not. You know, I slept pretty well the day before the draft because I was so tired. So, but even though I was excited, but I don't know. We're going to see.
How does this compare to the other first so far, the summer league game and the preseason game? This one feels very different.
This one feels unreal even more, you know. I thought maybe like a month ago that some preseason games would prepare me for that moment and that it would be like just another game maybe, but it feels totally different. Just the fact that it's an actual NBA preseason regular season game, you know. It is different.
Victor, so many people are talking about what they expect you to do, and I mean, you know what.
Are they?
Yes. What do you think you can do in the NBA? What type of career are you looking at NBA?
I want to win as many titles as I can in the long run. I know it's not something easy to do. Many, and most players have their career and never get to even the finals or to win championship. But it's one of my biggest goals in life. So I know I'm gonna reach this one day or the other, and it's all I'm dedicating the next I don't know how many years in my life to reach this, and I'm ready to sacrifice anything.
Victor, one thing that you haven't had a chance to do so far is play fourth quarter of a game that matters. Are you looking forward to that and seeing how you handle that?
Of course, I miss it. You know, it's been months, and I know, you know, this is. I know nobody has seen my best side so far because, you know, I haven't gotten to finish games yet in preseason, but it's gonna be interesting.
Would you consider yourself a clutch player?
Oh yeah, yeah, for sure.
Victor, everybody's been talking about the defense, your teammates, Coach Pop. How excited are you for the possibilities on that end of the floor with the group that you guys are running out and for the test in facing players like Doncic, Kyrie?
You know, I've just learned so much ever since I came here. In offense, of course, for the set plays and the principles of the game, but in defense, I've played a role that I had never had before, you know. And I really love it. I love learning, and I've learned just so much, experiencing so much new stuff, even just at practice, that I'm really, really excited, and it's promising. I think we've learned quicker than I expected. So yeah, the possibilities on defense are endless with that team, and it's gonna be, over the years, it's gonna be even more.
Kind of touched on the experimentation there. Has Pop been using you in ways where you're like, oh, I didn't even think about me doing that myself? Like, is there anything that's kind of...
Let's say I thought about doing some stuff before, but you know, in the teams I played with, it was our league was just so competitive that, I mean, in the past that we couldn't really experiment, like, because maybe just... You know, 5 minutes of experimenting a new role for me in defense, who've always been pretty important defensively for my teams, it was a huge risk, you know. So it's just stuff I thought about doing, but never really had either the time or the opportunity to do.
The NBA is already an international game, but do you feel someone like you coming in with all the fanfare? There's never really been a foreign player coming in with the fanfare you're receiving. Can you take it to a different level? Do you hope to expand the NBA's popularity around the world? Do you think you can?
Oh, I mean, it is going to be, you know, I'm sure it's going to happen, and it's happening already, you know, because I think some more French people especially are getting interested to the NBA maybe, which I'm really glad. But just for basketball, NBA internationally, but especially for France, it's, yeah, it's one of my, one something I hold dear in my heart to yeah, to expand basketball in France.
Did you see a video of the Dallas coaches using the paddles to stimulate you? What did you think about that?
I mean,
not a good simulation, I don't think.
I mean, anything's good to, you know, anything that can help, but it's funny, but it's not like it's something really, really new. People have done this before.
Yeah.
Chetty said yesterday he's been trying to push you a little, value a little bit in practice. Has that been, what's that been like? And do you expect, you know, now that the regular season's here, teams to get a little physical with you?
Yeah, but, you know, everyone's got their strength. And, you know, it's being physical is something I've seen I've seen my whole life, basically, you know, every time I stepped on a court for the last years. And so it's not something I'm afraid of. And, you know, quickness beats physicality when used correctly, you know. It's really, it's part of the game. Like, I'm used to it.
For this season, your expectations, how much do you want to play? I know there's been talk about how, you know, resting you at that certain point, but what do you want to do?
Every game, you know, if there's no excessive risk for my health, of course I can predict the future, but I want to play every single game.
Do you remember what was going through your
record? 14 players from France in the league this year. Does that go back to?
Was it a record?
Yeah.
It's all time, really? Yeah,
for France. What do you attribute that to? And is that a point of pride for you?
What do I attribute that to? You know, it's, I mean, I think on the international scene, people start to know that France is really next up. And it really shows, you know, lots of talent already, but lots of incoming talent too. And it's, I mean, I'm really hopeful. I couldn't be more proud. it's really a chance to be part of that, to be coming from that country. And I think we got a chance to really show off in the next years. What was the question again?
No, you answered it.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Jeff, thank you.
Do you remember what was going through your mind on draft lottery night as all the different teams went off the board and it finally came up San Antonio?
Yeah. To this day, it's still one of the best nights in my life. You know, it was really a great event, surrounded with people I loved. You know, and What was going through my mind? So I had the conviction that the Spurs were gonna get it, but still I'm not gonna lie, it was a kind of stressful moment, you know, and a very, very weird, you know, feeling.
How would you grade yourself if you had to give yourself?
We're done with English. We're gonna start in French. Maxime, go ahead. Thank you.
Victor, pour parler justement de la France, on a parlé, mais je vois qu'il y a beaucoup de journalistes français ici, il y a un engouement énorme en France. À quel point ça te porte aussi, cet engouement qui vient de France?
Bah, moi, c'est bien sûr que les fans de San Antonio me soutiennent, ça fait plaisir, mais que ce soit des fans qui viennent de France, c'est encore pire, quoi. Et des fois, je vois des drapeaux français dans les tribunes, je fais toujours un signe, j'essaie toujours de dire bonjour ou de taper les mains, parce que enfin voilà, ça fait plaisir, c'est comme c'est mon sang, quoi.
Victor, vous allez demain, dans un peu moins de 24 heures, vivre un rêve, comme vous le disiez, dont vous vous souvenez depuis que vous êtes bébé. Quelles sont les manifestations physiques que vous ressentez à cette idée? Est-ce que c'est des papillons dans le ventre, comme disait
Yann? Ouais, un peu, hein.
Parler un peu de ce ressenti.
Ouais, des papillons dans le ventre. Un peu. Moi, c'est un peu avant chaque match. Après, ça dépend de l'enjeu, des enjeux, bien sûr, de l'importance du match. Mais ouais, c'est ça. Enfin, après, rien de... Je ne me mets pas à trembler et à transpirer non plus, mais ouais, c'est, voilà, c'est comme ça. Un peu mal au ventre.
Bonjour Victor, de RMC. Comment tu as embrassé la vie de San Antonio? Parce qu'on a rencontré des fans, ils sont excités par tes talents de basket, mais aussi par le fait que tu t'inclus vraiment dans la communauté, les tacos, les chapeaux, les fresques que tu as signées. Ouais. Comment tu te sens dans cette vie?
Bon, disons qu'il n'y a rien à... rien à redire, quoi. C'est tout le monde, j'ai pas vu une personne qui était négative envers moi depuis que je suis arrivé. Et disons que c'est le meilleur environnement dans lequel je puisse être. Et je sais que, surtout, quand tout va bien, c'est en disant que c'est facile de soutenir, mais je sais que les fans de San Antonio, c'est leur loyauté, elle est au-dessus de n'importe quelle autre fanbase. Donc je sais que même dans les moments difficiles, ils seront là, quoi.
Victor, quelles ont été les consignes du coach et du staff pour demain, pour toi personnellement? Qu'est-ce que tu as le droit de dire?
Ce que j'ai le droit de dire, disons que il a fini tout simplement des conseils très simples. Faut jouer plus dur et plus intelligemment que l'adversaire. Et le reste, tout part de là. C'est ce qu'il a dit. Et je pense que c'est important. Parce que dans les matchs spéciaux, à enjeu, importants comme le premier match de la saison, on a tendance à se perdre dans les attentes personnelles, dans la tactique un peu trop, mais au final, je suis dur et intelligent.
Victor, la NBA, c'est le plus haut niveau du basket mondial. Demain, c'est Luka Doncic, c'est Kyrie Irving. Vous êtes un compétiteur. Est-ce que là, vous avez le sentiment que vous allez pouvoir vous tester? On a beaucoup parlé depuis 3 mois, là, c'est la compétition qui commence. Sentiment que vous allez pouvoir vous tester contre les meilleurs joueurs du monde et ça doit susciter de l'excitation?
Bien sûr, oui, beaucoup d'excitation. Après, en NBA, c'est toutes les semaines qu'on a des super joueurs ou des All-Stars en face de nous, quoi. Donc tous les matchs sont vraiment spéciaux.
Salut Victor, merci de nous accueillir ici avec les Spurs. Il y a des milliers de Français qui vont te regarder demain à 2h, 3h du matin. Toi aussi, tu as peut-être connu ça.
3h30
3h30 du matin, tout à fait. Il y a aussi des moments que toi, tu as pu vivre où aussi il fallait regarder la NBA la nuit. Quel message tu as envie de dire à toutes ces personnes qui, en fait, vont te regarder demain à 3h30 du matin et toute la saison, qui vont rester tard?
Faites-le plein de café, hein. Mais ça fait plaisir, c'est bien sûr. C'est comme je disais, dès que je vois du soutien, que je remarque du soutien, encore plus des Français, j'essaie de remercier, de montrer que ça me touche. Et voilà, j'espère pouvoir rendre bien sûr l'appareil un jour ou l'autre. Et j'espère que vous avez kiffé toute la saison.
Last one from Vincent, go ahead.
Comment tu t'es senti dans le rythme? Tu as joué 20 minutes à chaque fois. Est-ce que le cardio, t'as des surprises ou est-ce que ça
correspond? C'est différent au niveau cardio. Je dirais pas que c'est plus dur au niveau cardio, mais c'est un cardio différent. Il y a beaucoup plus de contacts, comme le terrain est plus petit, il y a beaucoup plus de contacts en Europe. Mais ici, ça court et ça saute comme nulle part, comme dans aucun autre sport en fait. Et donc c'est deux choses différentes. Du coup, il y a un petit temps d'adaptation. Ouais. Je pense qu'il y aura encore une adaptation. Ce que j'aime bien, c'est qu'il y a souvent il y a plus de temps mort, j'ai l'impression, ou alors ils sont plus longs. Mais et donc ça permet vraiment de pourquoi c'est drôle.
Temps mort TV,
c'est ça. Et donc en fait même si ça court énormément, il y a le temps de se reposer, quoi.